శైలం. విత్ ప్రణామ్స్ ది లోటస్ ఫీట్ ఆఫ్ భగవాన్. డియర్ బ్రదర్స్ అండ్ సిస్టర్స్, థ్యాంక్స్ స్వామి ఫర్ హ్యావింగ్ బ్రాట్ అస్ అగైన్ టు దిస్ ఈవినింగ్ సెషన్. యాజ్ యూ హ్యావ్ బీన్ డూయింగ్ ఆల్ అలాంగ్, వీ హ్యావ్ బీన్ డూయింగ్ ఇట్ ఫ్రమ్ బ్యాక్వర్డ్స్. అండ్ ఆల్ దిస్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు స్పీక్ వాస్ published in Telugu Sanatana Sarathi in the month of December 2000. Yes, the year 2000, particularly the month of November, which happens to be the birthday of Bhagwan, November 23rd, has a special significance. Bhagwan started village work entrusted to students during that year, 2000, November. Well, boys have been asked to take up this village work. What they did was, students in different groups visited so many villages in and around Puttaparthi and made a thorough survey of every village. And Bhagwan called them all, students and teachers, and said, "Look here, I am sending you to villages, giving you an opportunity to serve the villagers there. I want you to serve them food, give them food packets. I want you to give them sweets. I want you to give them clothes. And I want you to see that you do not forget anybody. Every villager should necessarily receive these gifts of grace." Bhagwan was very particular about it. And he gave them all the possible directions in this connection. I should also bring to your attention that about 35 lorries are deployed for this purpose, to carry students to different villages. 35 lorries. Apart from the lorries, the other four wheelers were also put to work. Well, boys were divided into batches and they were given the lorry numbers and they have to get into the lorries and be ready to go to the villages. My friends, here I want to let you know that the true India is in villages. The Indian culture could well be known only in villages. The cities like Bombay, Hyderabad, Lucknow, Delhi, as you see them today, they have little traces of Indian culture left. But into the interior of the villages, you find today Indian culture still followed. So Swami wanted this rural development program to be taken up by the students as a part of their study, so that they know the village life. They will know the problems in a village. They will also know how to face these problems, the solutions to these problems. Rather, it's a part of their study. And who is the leader to whom we can look up to as an ideal in this rural activity? I can tell you, Bhagwan Sri Sat Sai Baba is the best possible guide, ideal, to whom we can look up to follow and to emulate his example. You may ask me why and how. When Bhagwan was born here, there were about 100 residences, that's all. There were about 100 houses in this village, Puttaparthi. And today, it is a global village. It's a global village. In those days, there was no power supply, no electricity. And today, we have electricity and electronic gadgets of the latest order. Those days, there were no schools at all. And today, we have a university. In those days, there was not even a primary health center. No medical facility. And today, we have a super specialty hospital. And in those days, people had to walk kilometers and kilometers to fetch a pot full of water. And today, drinking water supply scheme is extended that we get water out of the taps almost in every room at every residence. This is what a rural development program is. To this stature, Bhagwan has developed the village. That the village then has been transformed into a global village as we see it today. Now, around 75,000 saris were distributed to women. 75,000 dhotis, villages, dhotis, were distributed to men. 75,000 school uniforms were distributed to school children during that 10-day service activity. And here, let me also speak to you the modus operandi or the procedure adopted. We have from Anantapur campus girls, around 1,000 girls worked throughout night to make food packets ready for distribution by the boys. They start packing the material around 1 o'clock in the midnight. It will go on till 7:30 or 8 o'clock. 1,000 girl students, supervised by teachers, they make food packets, 2 packets. One the sweet, other the hot. And we have to give these packets to every member of every family in every village, every day. So you can imagine what sort of work it is. And cooking starts at 10 o'clock in the night. And it is quite unbelievable. I don't know what to call it. Fireplaces where cooking was done. Above hundreds and hundreds of utensils, hundreds and hundreds of cooks, as if some very big yajna was going on. Floodlights all over. It's only possible for Baba to have the work done at that magnitude. Impossible for anybody. And all food packets, they were ready by 7:30 in the morning. And there are special teams of students to load these lorries with huge baskets containing the packets depending upon the number of houses and the number of residents at every home. So all these lorries are loaded with foodstuff and full of students in every lorry. They start here every day in the morning, do some bhajan, receive Baba's blessings, come out. You must have seen. They get into lorries and the lorries would go to long distances of villages and return by the evening, bhajan time. And boys have to eat there. Few packets are kept for boys also. They eat that what they distribute. Nothing special about it. This is really something very grand. And about 350 villages were selected for this rural development program. And see our Bhagwan, the meticulous care. As lorries start off to their destinations, after half an hour, Bhagwan used to send additional lorries with food packets and lorries and clothes. Additional. Why? In case we run short of stock, this could be used immediately. And nowhere there was any shortage of food packets or clothes. Because we have got additional supplies of lorries coming behind us, sent by Bhagwan. It's really a very, very beautiful experience. And in addition to that, there are some students traveling in cars with wireless sets. With wireless sets, giving instructions to everybody. Lorry number 4, where is it? How many packets are there? Lorry number 10, how many students are there? How many packets? Sir, packets are over. Is there additional truck behind? As if some military camp was going on. Some military. I don't think that even war camps also will have that kind of perfection as I have seen there. Because these boys are all MSc students, M.Tech students. They put all their technology for this work. But it was amazing. Sir, Anil Kumar, sir, in which lorry is he? 10th lorry or 12th lorry? Sir, please stop the lorry. Anil Kumar, sir, is missing. Very interesting, you know, very interesting. And there was no confusion at all at any point of time, at any point of time. And there in the villages, what they did was, immediately they get down from every lorry, they do Nagar Sankirtan in the village and then start food distribution from one point so that the whole village will be vibrant with God's name. And I too participated in this activity in my own humble way, traveling in lorries and all that, jumping and all that. And most surprisingly, every village, wherever we stop, hundreds of children, shouting, and they're coming over there. All big people, all residents, grand gala welcome. A big festival in every village. And we should also see here Swami's comments, which are even more important. My attempt is not merely to describe what happened during that time. The message behind is more important. Because this rural development program was just an excuse to convey the divine message to everybody. After our return in the evening, we always found Swami waiting for us. Just standing there. All lorries have come? No. Why? Who is in charge? Call that fellow. Why? 5 lorries are yet to come? Why? What happened? Very anxious, very nervous. Much more than a mother waiting for the kid. In case the kid returns home late by half an hour, the mother will have blood pressure and all those things. The Sai, the Divine Mother, had all the anxiety. What happened? Swami, they are on the way. Why? Why have come before? Leaving them. All lorries should come at a time, you understand? Ambo. Well, we didn't dare to face him at all. And there were also occasions when we stopped lorries at the outskirts to make sure that all lorries assembled. Because to see that we are safe here as we face Bhagwan. And after return, one of those days, one lecturer said to Swami, "Swami, when we are distributing food packets, everybody were very happy to receive those packets. Of all religions, Muslims and Christians, everybody received food packets." Baba said, "Don't speak like that. Why do you say Muslims and Christians? Hunger is same to everybody. There is nothing like Muslim appetite, Hindu appetite, and Christian hunger. Useless fellow. All need food. Food is same. Hunger is same. There is nothing like Muslim and Christian. Fact, keep quiet." That's what he said. And then he also said, "Make sure that you visit every house and talk to them with a smile. Tell them, 'Sir, Bhagavan Sri Sai Baba has sent prasadam to you. He has sent clothes to you. Let's know how many men are here, how many women are here, how many children are here. We are ready with these things. Distribute like that. Talk softly and sweetly so that they will have best of opinion of our institution. And remember, better you take more packets than required. Never go with exact number and never take less number than what is required." He was very sure about it. And he said, while distributing food, do bhajans. It's a lesson to everybody, my friends. As we do our work, let us do bhajans. One may be in the kitchen, one may be in the dining hall, one may be in the work spot. We can do bhajans. Why not? Bhajans give us a sort of additional boost, additional strength. This is a message to everybody. Then he said, first give prasadam, next clothes. This is the Indian tradition. We don't give the clothes first and serve food later. Serve food first and clothes next. That's very important. That's what Bhagavan said. And then be respectful. Show respect to everybody. And be respected. Let you be respected later. By showing respect to others, you'll be respected in turn. That's what Bhagavan said. And he also said, it is not enough if you have sufficient energy to serve. You need interest also. There are people who have energy, they go on doing things. And if you are simply energetic, you are mechanical. Mere energy is not enough. You show some interest, some dynamism, some leadership, some activity, some cheer, so that you will gladly do it. That's what Bhagavan said. And then, Bhagavan, waiting for the boys there in the veranda every day, ready with baskets full of apples, and starts distributing one apple to every boy, stares at every boy, looks deep into the eyes of another boy, makes fun of each and every one of them. It is a sight for gods. Sight for gods. And I can also tell you, when we mention the names of certain villages, our good God recalls his past association 60 years ago and tells when he visited that place, whom he visited at that place, and how he spent his time there. This is an extra bonus to all the students. They forget all the strain, they forget the tiresomeness, and they laugh when Swami starts speaking about his good old days, 6 years ago, when he visited those villages at a distance. For example, we mentioned the name of one village by name Janakampalli, J-A-N-A-K-A-M-P-A-L-L-I, KAMPALLI, Janakampalli. Immediately Swami said, oh, 60 years ago I went to that village. I spent good number of days there. There is one Reddy family there. That man must have been very old now. Did you meet him? Yes, Swami, we met them. And he told us how you made him happy. How you stayed there with them. Oh, I see. Bhagavan was happy. And then I just asked Swami, what did you do there in that village 60 years ago? What? Same thing. Discourses? Prasadam? Same thing. Oh, I see. Swami, people assembled. Ayayya! All neighboring villages, full of people there. And I used to talk to them. Oh, Swami. And then Swami started talking about another point. He asked somebody, where did you go? Swami, we went to one village by name Enumalapalli. 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 Oh, I see. Did you go there? Yes. On the way, there are two mad people. Did you give them prasadam? See that? Yes, Swami, we give. If you go still further, there is an old man who cannot stand also. Did you give him prasad? Yes, Swami. And when you go to the bypass road, there is an old blind fellow. Did you give him prasad? See that. He was telling where people stayed, ensuring the prasadam received or not. That the meticulous care that Bhagavan has taken about our activity. Then we said, Swami, we had been to another village by name Karnataka Nagepalli, KARNATAKA NAGEPALLI, Karnataka Nagepalli. Oh, I see. Swami said, oh, I stayed there for a long time. I used to go there almost every alternate day. But Karnataka Nagepalli, here very close to this, full of mountains and thick forest. Swami as a boy used to run away into the forest, climb up mountains, stayed there. And parents and Karanam Subbamma, KARANAM, Subbamma, who was very fond of Baba in his childhood, who served Swami right from his childhood. And she was a very rich lady in this village. So all looked at her with all esteem and respect. So this lady went on in search of Baba where he was, because she carries food every day. Where is this Baba? On the mountain top or deep in the forest? What to do? So this lady, being rich lady from rich family, she used to take along with her two grown-up pailmans, well-built fellows, along with her to search where Baba is and to carry him in their arms. Because little Baba, whether he would be able to walk all along or not, to carry him in their arms. This is what Bhagavan went on telling those days. And then we made a mention of another village, Kunkalapalli, KUNKALAPALLI, Kunkalapalli. Swami said, what did you see there? Swami, we met 400 people. They are all Tamilians. They came from a long distance, working as casual labor there in the fields. When we were distributing clothes and food packets, we saw on their faces tears of love. tears of thankfulness and tears of gratitude. Swami, we were so happy. Another gentleman said, Swami, we had been to another village by name Dupampalli, D-U-P-A-M-P-A-L-L-I. And they said, the boys that went to that village, Dupampalli, they said, Swami, all local villagers started singing their own bhajans, not our Prashanti bhajans. Every village has got its own local culture, as I said. They have got their own local bhajan songs, full of philosophy, in very simple language. And Swami was very happy. I see. And then the lecturer in charge said, Swami, when we said, Baba sent prasadam to you, Baba sent clothes to you, well, they could not control their emotion. Most of them burst into tears, Swami. They are really lost in ecstasy. And then, I should also make a mention of a town by name Dharmavaram. Dharmavaram, most of you must have known that. D-H-A-R-M-A-V-A-R-A-M, Dharmavaram. We had been to that town, and it was 9:30 by the time we returned. 9:30 in the night. Because it was thickly populated town. And I tell you, till 9:30, our good God was waiting there in the veranda. He did not have a sip of water till then. He cancelled bhajans. He cancelled interviews. Standing there in the veranda till 9:30, waiting for the boys. Can you estimate his love for the boys? Can you ever imagine his concern for the boys? Unimaginable. And then we had been to many villages, all the names not necessary, because the names are more confusing. But I can tell you what some of the villagers expressed when we had been to those places. We met one old man coming close to us. Boys, look here. I got my eye operated there in Sri Satsai Hospital. So I am able to see today. I am able to earn my bread because my sight is normal. And then at another place, we find another man coming to us. Sir, look here. I got my heart operated in Sri Satsai Super Speciality Hospital. Had I not been operated, the whole family would have been on the streets. And the only breadwinner, Baba gave me second life. It is a thrilling experience to hear people telling how they were benefited by Baba's service institutions. And the boys also responded to the call of Bhagwan, responded to the message of Bhagwan. Well, what they did was, while the lorry was coming towards Puttaparthi, on our return, wherever they found some people working in the fields, they stopped the lorries, carried food packets to those agriculturists and farmers working there. That made Swami very, very happy. And then, in certain villages, on coming to know that Baba's students are coming there, they made special village level of decorations. Grand gala welcome to everybody. And they started singing songs in praise of Bhagwan and gave us tumultuous welcome to all of us. And in some villages, we saw people coming close to us and telling, Sir, we had no water till now. We were getting water from the neighboring village. Thanks to Swami, we have water available here in this village. Thanks to Swami, what they said. In some other village we met few Muslims who came and said, "Sir, Baba constructed mosque for us, a place of worship for Muslims, dargah. Baba constructed the dargah, mosque for us to pray." We are very grateful to him. These are all the acts of Bhagwan, which will tell us that he loves all religions. All religions are one. The truth is one. Only paths are many. The goal is many. Goal is one, I'm sorry. Paths are many. Destination is one. Worship procedure may be different. Practices may be different. But God is one. That is the message. And in some villages, the poor people, they had spread out mat on the ground. "Boys, please sit down. Please sit down." They were telling, "Shall we give you some water? Cold water is there. Please have water." Some people were offering buttermilk. Some people said, "Boys, you don't know the villages. Shall we give you a few groundnuts to eat? Please don't refuse. We have some groundnuts. Eat them." And some villagers gave them the sugar canes. "Come on, would you eat it?" They were extending their hospitality, courtesy and reception in their own way. That is really very grand, grand. And these boys, most of them, are from cities. In cities, nobody is bothered of anybody. Even if the neighbor is on deathbed, he is not concerned. Even there is wedding in neighbor's house, he is not bothered. That is city culture. Particularly those that stay in flats. Flat culture. Nothing. Life is flat. No human relationships. No courtesies. No acquaintances. No social contacts. We don't know who is neighbor. I don't know. And we are not ashamed of it. We call it culture and civilization. But in villages it's not like that. They are all one. They cooperate with each other. And what a humility, courtesy they have, obedience. With nice reception, folded hands, "Please come, sir." In cities we don't find it. If they find any stranger, "Hi." That's all. Nobody will say, "Sir, what do you want? May I help you?" Nobody will say, That's all. The fellow, the stranger will be afraid of these faces. Because no welcome, no concern. So the boys coming from the cities, watching this kind of hospitality and reception, they could not believe their eyes, I tell you. And moreover, the kind of devotion in villages. The villagers are innocent. They are poor and pure. They had no doubts. But most of the fellows from cities, highly educated, the head full of doubts, no faith in God, and they have no faith in themselves. No love anywhere. That's what the cities are today all over the world. So the education of the heart is educare. That's what we find in villages. The knowledge of the head is education. The knowledge of the head is education. The feelings, values, and the sentiments of the heart is educare. That's what we find in villages. In cities, the pomp, show, publicity, pride, ego, vanity are the common features. Humility, simplicity, reverence, respect, faith, obedience, courtesy, concern, sympathy, forbearance, These are the values of the villagers. We are very grateful to Bhagavan for having given us this opportunity to visit the villagers and to gain experience while serving them, to know what the Indian culture is, what it stands for in true spirit. That has been the experience of all the boys. And they went on asking Swami every year, "Swami, shall we go this year also?" With the result, the rural development program, Grama Seva, G-R-A-M-A, has been going on for the last 2 years. I think you know that. Because boys were asking Swami for permission to participate, foregoing their vacation. You know that? Usually in our places, people want to go home during vacation, enjoy with parents and friends the cookies and special preparations. But here boys, they don't want vacation. They want this service activity. This is quite an unbelievable phenomena. Now, I go to the next month and share with you few points, and these details are published in Telugu Sanatana Sarathi in the month of October 2000. I am sure that I am presenting these things in chronological and sequential order to the best of my ability, although there are some pressing engagements and appointments right now, particularly at a time when the academic year is coming to a close and the boys to be ready for examination, and we the teachers are in a hurry to complete our syllabus. But I am also particular to complete this syllabus. This is also equally syllabus. I am particular to complete this so that we'll have some time left there in Bangalore to do this homework. Now, a few points regarding this October 2000 episodes. Well, Bhagavan has with him students from all states, from all over the country, and few students are from overseas also. And you know how difficult it is to adjust to the food habits. You know, when you are asked to take spicy food in South Indian canteen, I can imagine your reaction. I cannot even imagine you eating pickles in my dream. Impossible. Because pickle will take you to land on the moon straight away without the help of any satellite or spacecraft. That's my regular diet, you know. I eat lot of chilies, lot of stuff. Yes. Right from the beginning it has been my body constitution. You know, that's the thing, you know. And the boys here, there in the north, they have chapatis. Those coming from the south, they have sambar and rasam. But all boys have to eat the same food there in the hostel. Just imagine how difficult it is. I remember my trip to United States in the year 1975. And I didn't have anything to eat there. I had been to the state of Indiana in the United States. I had been to Brazil, Indiana, Corydon, Indiana, Aurora, Indiana, Bloomington, Indiana, Terre Haute, Indiana, Indianapolis. I had been to so many places there. But I didn't have anything to eat. But everybody knows that I'm a vegetarian. But what they did was, they used to bring a big bowl with potato totally crushed into a paste. Anil Kumar, you are a vegetarian. But they are very nice people. I have not yet seen such friendly people till now. They love me. Friendly people. But the potato is certainly vegetarian food. How can I say it's non-vegetarian? It's not. So how can you eat the paste? So for courtesy, for good manners, I said, very nice, thank you very much. But some of them were watching me what I would eat. Because I had to be there for 6 weeks as their guest. They should send me home intact and alive. So they used to watch me. Well, somebody could understand this fellow is not eating. And some very good people, I tell you, very good people. And some of them Americans, they came close to me and said, Mr. Anil, no. You're not eating dear anything. You're not eating. Please let's know what you really care for. Let's know. I'll cook for you, Mr. Anil, what? So I tell them I eat hot stuff and all that. I said, don't bother, I'm fine. Finally, what they thought was, they said, do you like cakes, Mr. Anil Kumar? Yes. Do you like biscuits? Oh, yes. Chocolates? Oh, yes. Milkshake? Why not? Ground nuts? Very much. Cashew nuts? Immediately. With the result, my dining table was full of these cakes and breads, bun, milkshake, wah, wah, wah. Whereas the non-vegetarian fellows had only one or two items. I had so many. And please believe me, I was more energetic than all those fellows put together. Living on cakes, biscuits, milkshake, cashew nut, ground nut, cream, wow. Cheese, pizza, wow. Why I told you was, so difficult to adjust ourselves in a different land with our food habits. With the result, what those people did was, such fine people, I cannot forget them for a lifetime. My next host used to ring up to the present host. Mr. Anil Kumar is going to be with us next week. Please tell us what is he going to eat. Rice. Good. Two, some chutneys. We'll have some Indian restaurant, some stuff for him. Three, he's afraid of dogs and cats, guinea pigs. I see. We'll keep them safe in a room and lock it. Okay. Number four, he is very fond of hot coffee. Alright. Number five, he likes to give number of speeches. Alright, we'll arrange few meetings. Okay. And he likes to socialize with people, talk to American friends, know their culture. Noted. We'll invite you. And one, of course, this is all my personal experience, thinking that you'll certainly enjoy, I'm telling you. One day, somehow, I felt, what shall I do? Very serious. All Americans have smiling faces. Oh, yes. And yet to find an American with a serious face. No. All smiling faces with bubbling enthusiasm. Anil, why are you serious? What's wrong with you? Are you okay? I'm fine. Why are you so serious? No. I want to sing for you tonight. Sing? Yes, why not? Some bhajan songs. Bhajan? What is it? The spiritual songs. And I'll give English meaning also. Please invite your friends also. With the result, please believe me, from that day I had 200 people, American families, hearing my talks. Enjoying my company, I enjoyed their company. And the last day, all of us started crying because we could not part with each other. So, with all said and done, be that as it may, What I want to tell you, so difficult to adjust the food habits. Boys coming from Himalayas, from far off places, they take rasam, sambar. It is their love for Bhagwan. Or it is not possible. Well, why that far? How are you here? Listening to the music of mosquitoes at night. Leaving your own food that you relish very much. But how, what is that made you here still smile and continue to stay here? Is your devotion to Bhagwan. There's no doubt about it. I feel so humble. I feel so little in front of you. Believe me or not. In front of all foreigners, I feel very, very sorry. Because how is that I am not able to adjust? How is that these people are able to adjust here? So, you are the chosen children of Bhagwan Baba. Not that with a word of praise I am talking to you. I am speaking from the bottom of my heart. I really mean it. So, as Swami talks to them, suddenly he looked at a fellow. Come on, boy. You have stomach problem, right? Yes, Swami. Stomach pain. Oh, I see. Then Swami laughed and said, see, Anil Kumar, this boy is from North India. He is used to chapatis, rotis, parotas. And here in our hostel, he has to take sambar and rasam. So stomach upset problem, poor fellow. Don't worry. He materialized tablets for him. Tablets. I'm giving you 3 tablets. Take one. Take one tonight. One tomorrow morning. You'll be free. That is God. People are here for the love of Swami. And Swami is here for the love of humanity. It is the love that made both of us to stay here. That's what I think. And then, we also find people from different countries sitting in circles every day, talking about Swami's message, practicing bhajan songs, which Swami tells everybody. You have to learn from those people. Every second, they make best use of their time, thinking of Swami, practicing bhajans. It is really great. Mind you, I am talking all these things from the published book of Sanatana Sarathi, which is Ashram magazine, which has divine approval and sanction, where single word cannot be an exaggerated one. It should be correct, accurate to the fact. That's all. So what I am telling is recorded here. So that you will know that it has Swami's approval and sanction. I should also tell you I met Spanish speaking people, carrying with them certain books of Sanatana Dharma, the names of which are not known to Hindus. Some of those names. Some of those books are not read by us. But these people from Argentina, Peru, Venezuela, Brazil, Guatemala, carrying some books, bearing the title Tripura Rahasya, TRIPURA, RAHASYA, Tripura Rahasya, which has got the quintessence of philosophy, which I don't follow. But those people from Argentina, they read. It only speaks how Swami works within every one of us. When I told Swami, Spanish people read all these books, your literature, then Swami said, you fellows should learn from them. You go and learn from them. See, are you not ashamed of this? Swami, that's what there is. I am not also ashamed to tell you that I met few devotees from Argentina with some slip of paper. Amiyao, they call me Amiyao. Amiyao? You gave English translation to Sachidananda? You are wrong, okay? Am I wrong? Yes, you are. That's not what Baba said. You understand? I was jumping in joy. I felt like dancing. Spanish people correcting me that I was wrong in my translation. It only says their depth in the subject, their thoroughness in the subject, that they are particular to have correct translation, that I cannot do as I like it, that I cannot take things for granted, that I carry with me a heavy responsibility, that I am accountable to them, that I cannot think that all foreigners can say, thank you Anil Kumar, you are doing a good job. No, not necessary. There are quite a good number of people who say, you are wrong. Okay, you understand? Oh, I am sorry sister, thank you. I stand corrected. There are some that say, tell me, you are shouting, we are not able to make out anything. You understand it? Yes, sister, I understand. But I cannot help it. I cannot help it. Why? Because I am not a machine. When Swami says a statement with all emphasis, well, I should also convey with equal force. When Swami says, there is no selfishness in me, I cannot tell softly, there is no selfishness in me. The spirit is gone. All my educational institutions offer education free of cost. All my institutions are only to make you understand, I cannot dull Bhagwan's discourse. I cannot make his discourse insipid and tasteless. Pardon, bear with my shouting. I cannot help it. Please, beg your pardon. That's what I tell them. Some people say, you are very fast. Yes, I am fast. But understand my problem. When Swami speaks very fast, I cannot be slow. Before I complete my sentence, he'll complete 3 sentences already. Please imagine my position. He won't give me time. Instead of banging me like that, please pity me, my brother. Please pity me. Please pray for me. And there are also some foreigners who tell me, would you please tell Bhagwan to give you some time to translate? I said, I cannot take that risk. It's a very costly risk, I cannot do. I am afraid that I may be substituted. And there are some say that they came with a smile, oh Anil Kumar, you did 2 mistakes. Swami corrected you, right? I said, yes. Yes. I am so happy that you are attentive. I am so happy that you are attentive. And that you also enjoyed when I was a flop. When I went wrong, when Swami corrected me, you are happy, good. So I am giving you some entertainment also, for which you should thank me. I never take it personally. Whenever anyone comments like that, I don't take it personally. I enjoy it. Because they are telling their opinion. Nothing wrong about it. We are all devotees. We are brothers and sisters. One can be free and frank about it. There's nothing wrong. And these are the thing somehow I felt like sharing with you. And then I can also tell you one thing that I noticed. I got floppies with me, computer floppies, disks, carrying Sai literature classified under 1500 heads. Can you imagine? Canadians read Swami literature thoroughly, classified it under 1500 headings, made floppies for ready reference. Where am I when compared to those people? And they sent me printouts of about 2000 pages. My almara is full of those papers. What research is going on? And one Australian published a book, Satya Sai Compendium, I believe. Compendium, Australians. It's a big book. Swami's literature, like a dictionary in alphabetic order, they collected Swami's literature all over the world. Research on Satya Sai literature is going on intensively, particularly in the West, particularly abroad. A thorough study is going on. It is unbelievable that many books are published in the Russian language. Russia, where there is nothing like religion before, in the times of Stalin and Lenin. And today, Sai literature, and we have translators who are doing better job than Anil Kumar himself. These two, how nicely they are doing, how fast they speak, how enthusiastic they are, and without any paper, and they are doing it. Well, I can't do it. Hats off to both of you who are doing a really good job. Pardon? See that. There are two more L's. More and more. Whoa! I am afraid that you are going to make me unemployed very soon. But, please believe me, I'll be the happiest person if I am lost, if I am defeated in your hands. Yes, because our God made His children abroad far, far greater than His children very near Him. It speaks of the intensity of your devotion. So I prayerfully await a day when you will certainly excel me. You two have already excelled me. I am waiting to meet other two also. If you want, I will give you in writing. The following two Russians, sister so-and-so, brother so-and-so, have excelled me in translation. This I mean it in letter and spirit. Signed K. Anil Kumar. This is recorded there. You can show it to everybody. Yes. I'm so happy, you know. Every teacher would like to be lost in the hands of his own student. Yes. Every teacher wishes that his student should excel him. Yes. Every parent wishes that his children should excel them. Excel him. Don't you think so? So similarly, when you are there, what? I'm mighty happy about it. Okay, now, it so happened Swami started joking with a boy. He called him, "Arre boy, how is your brother?" That boy said, "Swami, very fine." "Uh-huh. He got married?" "Yes, Swami." "Did you give him clothes I have sent?" "Yes, Swami." "Did you give him ring I wanted?" "Yes, Swami." Tell him one thing. Let him not forget his young wife. Doesn't matter even if he has forgotten me. Doesn't matter even if he has forgotten me. Let him not forget his young wife. That's what Bhagavan has said. You see that? And Swami said, "Boys, look here. I shall not forget you, even if you forget me. I shall not forsake you, even if you forsake me. Who will tell that today? Tell me. That is Bhagavan Sri Satsai Baba. We'll continue tomorrow. I'm sorry, in today's recording, there's some personal note and some personal experience as a translator, which would as well make a topic for you to talk about. Anyway, I'm sorry if I've taken your time. I stand guilty I'm excused if I've taken your time. But somehow it has come like that on its own. Thank you very much. Sai Ram. Loka samatha sukhino bhavantu. Loka samatha sukhino bhavantu. Loka samatha sukhino bhavantu. Jai Bolo Bhagwan Sri Satsai Baba Ji Ki.